Hi students, I'm Sonia from Vidya Guru. We are starting a new session on current affairs. If you like this session, please press the like button for sure. Share the video with your friends and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. If you do that, you'll get the benefit of a whole lot of exam relevant videos which we upload. I'll start with the first question. Stay put, watch till the end because that's how I'll be able to, you know, make you learn all the questions because the questions are a little difficult but very, very significant from the point of view of every competitive exam. We'll start with the first question. Before starting that, I wish to tell you that this session is in English medium. If you're not comfortable with the language, the session in Hindi medium is also available in the playlist. Please look for that. That's there. The first question is about India's rank on Global Competitiveness Index. We have heard a lot about this index that India actually slipped 10 points and actually has reached to 68th position. Yes, India has slipped 10 places down. Now India's rank is 68th. Who prepares this index? We said that Global Competitiveness Index, this index is prepared by World Economic Forum. See, there are three things which are associated. You know, when I actually start talking about any index, I talk about two, three things which are relevant. So this question can be asked, like, who prepares Global Competitiveness Index? That is prepared by World Economic Forum. And the country which scored first position, that is Singapore. So Singapore first, India 68th, and World Economic Forum prepares Global Competitiveness Index. International Day of the Girl Child. I'm going to tell you the theme of it. But before that, let me tell you the date. The date is 11th October. The date is 11th October when International Day of the Girl Child is observed, and the theme was Girl Force Unscripted and Unstoppable. Unscripted and Unstoppable. International Day of the Girl Child is observed on 11th October. If the theme, I find the theme important, I actually write down then and there. The theme was Girl Force, Unscripted and Unstoppable. Don't forget the theme, even that is important. Greta Thunberg. Let's start the discussion about this girl. Teenage environmental activist from Sweden. Yes, the girl has become, you know, important for us. She has actually delivered a speech in UN. We've heard that. We all have. I'm saying that Greta Thunberg is from Sweden, teenage environmental activist. She's from Sweden, delivered, you know, a speech in UN. Apart from that, she was actually getting considered for Nobel Prize as well. That is why this girl has become that important now. So Greta Thunberg is from Sweden. That is why she's important. India-Mongolia military exercise. I'm going to tell you the venue of it and the name also. The name is Nomadic Elephant. Nomadic elephant, nomads, nomadic elephant, nomads. When we actually refer to the English word nomads, that means we are talking about people who do not have proper place to live. Wanderers, sort of wanderers, those who wander here and there, they are actually addressed as nomads, or we can call them gypsies also. So nomadic elephant is the name of the exercise. I'm going to tell you the venue of this exercise. That is Baklo. Baklo is in Himachal Pradesh. Nomadic elephant exercise between India and Mongolia, and I said the venue, Baklo, Himachal Pradesh. Next question is, first Indian to play 100 T20 international matches. That is Harmanpreet Kaur. This is happening for the first time. I said first Indian, Harmanpreet Kaur, first Indian, who got her name registered as the player who's going to play 100 T20 international match. So 100, more than 100, going to cross 100. So 100 T20 international matches this girl has played. Dharma Guardian military exercise. This exercise is between India and Japan. Name of the nations, that is also important. You know what happens when we actually learn the name of an exercise? That exercise has the name of the country also, but this is not happening here. That is why the names are important and a little difficult also. Dharma Guardian does not have India or Japan hidden in it. Dharma Guardian exercise is a military exercise between India and Japan. If I actually talk about the venue of it, the venue is Werengete and it is in Mizoram. Dharma Guardian exercise. The next question is World Migratory Bird Day. World Migratory Bird Day is observed on 11th May also and 12th October also. As we are, you know, studying the current affairs of October, that is why we'll actually study and focus on 12th October. The theme which was actually set for this year was Protect Birds. Protect Birds. Be the solution. Be the solution to the plastic pollution. World Migratory Bird Day is observed on 11th May and 12th October, and I said protect birds, be the solution to the plastic pollution. Suman initiative launched by, what is Suman? As actually I have written it in uppercase, that means you need to understand it has some sort of expanded form of it. Suman stands for Surakshit Matritva Ashwasan. Surakshit Matritva Ashwasan. That is actually the full form of the word Suman. It is an initiative launched by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare's Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan launched it. So I said, I'll actually write it like that. Health Ministry. Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has launched that. So I said this is the initiative, as you can make out by the expanded form Surakshit Matritva. That means we are referring to new mothers and newly born kids. You know, we all know that death rate is pretty high. So actually to protect, you know, them, to protect them and to stop all those newborn deaths, We have actually taken this initiative. The government has done that and this initiative is about that. So Suman initiative launched by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. The RBI reporting system for cooperative banks. We have heard, you know, a lot about PMC Bank and that is also a cooperative bank. So now RBI has taken a step to, you know, regulate them. So that step is SISB. And what is that? Central Information System for Banking Infrastructure. Central Information System for Banking Infrastructure. Central Information System for Banking Infrastructure. That is basically the reporting system by RBI for cooperative banks. The next question is Vajraprahar. It is an exercise between India and US. What kind of exercise? Military exercise. And when we actually talk about the venue of it is Seattle, but see, Seattle won't be sufficient. When I say only Seattle won't be sufficient, because in the exam there's a possibility they may write Washington also. So you have to be familiar that Seattle is a city in Washington. Washington referring to US. So Vajraprahar, an exercise between India and US, military exercise in Seattle, Washington. Indian firm UN Global Climate Action Award winner. There's an Indian firm, UN Global Climate Action Award winner, and that award is basically climate neutral now. And Infosys has got that. Infosys has got that. Yes, Indian firm, UN United Nations Global Climate Action Award winner. Country to offer tourist visas for the first time. Yes, Saudi Arabia is offering tourist visas. Saudi Arabia is offering tourist visas for the first time. How to avoid a climate disaster? And I'm going to tell you the name of the author. That is Bill Gates. It was in news that Bill Gates is planning to write something about climate change. So he has written that this book is How to Avoid a Climate Disaster is the book of Bill Gates. The next question is sister state link between Tamil Nadu and Fujian. So I'm going to write down the name of Fujian referring to China, and you must be thinking how did that happen, because we generally listen to such things about India and US. So this is when Xi Jinping, president of China, visited India a few days back. That means I'm referring to Prime Minister Modi and Xi Jinping, when two of them had an informal meeting in Mahabalipuram, Tamil Nadu. There, in that informal meeting, such a thing happened. Sister state link was established between Tamil Nadu and Fujian, China. The next question is, IMPS, Immediate Payment Service, Unified Payment Interface, that is UPI transactions. What is this TAT and why have I marked both the questions, 15th and 16th? That is turnaround time. Turnaround time, because RBI has done something new here. You know, you need to, you know, listen to that, that there's something new has happened. POS is point of sale, where you swipe your cards, point of sale. The other one is Aadhaar enabled payment system. The other one is e-commerce, where the card is in there, you're making the payments online. ATM transactions. So what is the news about these two, these things? So we'll start that. You know, when you make payments through these methods, there's a possibility that payment may get failed. This happens with all of us. What happens? We don't receive the payment instantly, but a charge will be levied on the bank. A charge will be levied on the bank if the payment is not received by the customer in one day's time. But that's the case with the upper question, 15th question. If your payment fails and bank is unable to reverse the payment in one day's time, in the case of IMPS and UPI, then they will be paying 100 rupees fine per day to the customer. So it is the charge which they'll be paying. And I said T plus one, where one shows one day, that's the time. But for these lower transactions, POS, APS, Aadhaar enabled payment system, online payments and ATM transactions, the option, the answer, the turnaround time is 5 days. 5 days. Here, within 5 days, bank has to reverse the failed payment in customer's account. If it does not happen, they have to pay 100 rupees fine per day to the customer. We'll start the revision. India's rank on Global Competitiveness Index is 68. World Economic Forum prepares that index and Singapore was on top. International Day of the Girl Child, 11th October, and the theme was Girl Force, Unscripted and Unstoppable. Greta Thunberg is from Sweden. Nomadic Elephant, India-Mongolia exercise and the venue, Baklo HP, Himachal Pradesh, first Indian to play 100 T20 international matches, Harmanpreet Kaur. Dharma Guardian military exercise between India and Japan, and when we actually refer to the venue of this exercise, that place is Werengete, Mizoram. World Migratory Bird Day is observed on 12th October as well as 11th May, and the theme for this year was set, Protect Birds, Be the Solution to Plastic Pollution. Suman is Surakshit Matritva Ashwasan Initiative, launched by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. SISB is the solution of RBI for basically the cooperative banks. Is the solution given by RBI for cooperative banks? We have heard about PMC crisis. That is why RBI has come up with SISB, that is Central Information System for Banking Infrastructure. Write down the full form and not SISB, please. Vajra Prahar is the exercise between India and US military exercise. Seattle, Washington, US is the venue for it. Indian firm, UN Global Climate Action Award winner, that is Infosys. Country to offer tourist visas for the first time, Saudi Arabia. Bill Gates has written How to Avoid a Climate Disaster. That's the name of his book. Sister state link between Tamil Nadu and Fujian, China. 1 day is the limit turnaround time. 5 day is the turnaround time in the case of POS, Aadhaar enabled payment system and e-commerce ATM transactions. Wrapping up. Thank you.